Good evening, everyone. I hope everyone's having fun tonight, and I hope that I get my point to you. Okay, I'm going to talk about World War II. During World War II, only four major systems had a major contribution to this war. The first one was fascism from Italy, Nazism from Germany, capitalism from the Soviets, and communism from the Soviets, and imperialism from Japan. Imperialism was the only Eastern philosophy included in this war, and it also had a major flaw in it. In imperialism philosophy, the emperor was considered like a god to them. Everything he said, everything he wanted done, must be done for him. So what did the people who were not pleased with him do? How did the people react? The higher-ups would just assassinate this emperor and let an heir rule and take his place and just manipulate this kid. This Eastern philosophy was so flawed that it cannot do anything to this world today. The second thing I want to talk about is the Western philosophy's contributions to this world today. One of the greatest achievements Western philosophy is capitalism, which was invented by John Locke. John Locke, he was an English philosopher. He introduced religious toleration. He insisted that governments should not force the people on a religion, that religion should be separated from governments. He also gave the people an answer to who should rule us. He said the governments should give the people what they need, their basic rights. The other thing he contributed to the world is the education system. He wrote the essay concerning human understanding, which inspired every educational system in every country nowadays. And this all came from this Western philosopher, which even Eastern countries use his philosophy. Another great philosopher was Adam Smith. He brought the theory of specialization to this world. He told this theory is applied in every company he can name any company, they use this theory of specialization, which is a division of labor, which each group has its own job or task to do, dividing the work, which will increase the production, develop the company, which is really important, such as Microsoft uses it, Apple uses it, Sony uses it, which is the Japanese company, Eastern company. So, if you look at Japan, look where it was, look where it is now. Japan is considered one of the most developed countries in the world. How did they get here? If you ask yourself this question, did they use their Eastern philosophies? No, they used Western philosophies. They used specialization, they used capitalism, which are all Western philosophies, to help them get back on their feet. So, if you really think about it, Western philosophies did save these Eastern countries. They are not waiting for the Eastern philosophies to save them. Because the philosophy that makes the country progress and move on has to be practical. Most Eastern philosophies are not for development or for moving forward. So, if Eastern philosophies can save the world, why are Eastern countries not using that philosophy to save themselves? They are actually using their Western philosophies to develop. And that's it. Thank you all. And I want to comment on the thing that the opposing team said. They say that Islam should be considered as an Eastern philosophy. Actually, you should separate because Islam, most of the Eastern philosophies are very different. Islam has one God. Eastern philosophies have like many things that are different than Islam. So yeah, that's it. You can compare Islam to the other Eastern philosophies. And thank you all for listening.